us direct or collect, 386-1161, or on your cell at Star 1070. It's Murray Langdon and Newsline PM on CFAX 1070.
Well, the election doesn't start for several months. Seven at least, by my count. Already we're hearing some election-type issues. A central Saanich mayoral candidate is calling for the amalgamation on the peninsula. Joining us to talk about this, and he's been part of our news run today on CFAX.
Hello.
Sean McNulty. Sean, how you doing?
Hey, great. How you doing?
All right, let's go more in depth with this, because I think folks making their way home might be curious to hear your stance on why you think it's best to pull all those municipalities together.
First clarify, it's central Saanich, North Saanich and Sydney, and yeah, I do think it's a great idea to pull them together. I think you save a lot economies of scale. I mean, you gain some economies of scale. I think there's a lot of duplications of jobs within the municipality that could then be amalgamated into one, another great savings for the taxpayers. And a big benefit, one of the ones I like the best about it, is instead of having 18 part-time councillors and 3 part-time mayors, out here on the peninsula specifically, you have 1 full-time mayor, 6 full-time councillors. You pay them enough that this can be their only job, right? And I think they'd serve their constituents far better. I mean, right now, Murray, the mayor job, for instance, for Central Saanich, pays $17,000 a year, right? And
right.
You're overseeing a budget of $18 million, right? So, I mean, at the same time doing it on a part-time basis. So, you know, I think there's some issues with that.
On the email already, someone responding in, maybe you know this person, Ali, says, I would amalgamate with Sean any day. What does that mean?
I'm not really sure what that would mean, but...
Where is this idea coming from? What spurned you on to take this stance, Sean? This has got to come from somewhere.
Well, I think, you know, being a resident and being involved in the area, and, you know, my family, we own and operate 2 businesses out here, in one in Keating Crossroad and then Island View Golf Center on the highway there, 5-star paving on Keating. Mm-hmm. I talked to a lot of people out here. I personally believe there's a lot of benefits there. I don't see a downside. And the people I talk to, a lot of people are want to see it happen. So, and again, I'm not advocating ramming it down everyone's throat, but what I'm saying is it should definitely be an issue that goes to referendum. Like, I think you got to let people decide. One of the problems is that I don't see the politicians, it's not in their best interest to move forward with something like that, because what you're doing is they're essentially voting away their position, right? Or they're making it that much harder for them to then retain their job as a councillor, as a mayor, right? So I think you got to get the issue's got to be voted on by the people of the peninsula, and then if they vote against it, hey, you know, fine, then they've spoken, and then we're good to go. But if they vote for it, then we can start moving forward with it and coming together.
Obviously, you have received some feedback, like you mentioned, that people are in support of this idea, or at least like to have it as part of the debate.
Yeah, I think it's definitely a highly debated issue, or a highly contested issue, or something that people talk about quite a bit. I was at the breakfast that the Peninsula Chamber put on, great event that they put on there, and it came up 2 questions. I guess I asked one of them, so one for me, but then one from another gentleman in the crowd. So it's definitely something that people want to talk about. It's kind of funny because the politicians don't seem to want to talk about it, but a lot of people want to talk about it. So I think let's get discussion over with, let's do the referendum, and either move forward with it or put it.
All right, if anyone else has an opinion out there, 386-1161, star 1070, or you can email us like a cheeky Ally did at talk@cfax1070.com. Give us your feelings on this amalgamation topic or suggestion, or amalgamation as a whole. I mean, really, Sean, when you look at the whole area, there's lots of chatter about this. There are some diehards that say, no, serious mistake, don't do it. Others that say, we should have done this years ago.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, I don't think anyone's saying we need more municipalities. I mean, 13 municipalities for a population base, which I guess is around 400,000, seems very excessive to me. I think we're definitely on the far end of having too many municipalities, that's for sure.
Let's go to the phones. Let's get people's opinions here. Don on a cell.
Yeah, in principle, the idea is good. I mean, you want amalgamation of services can be good, not necessarily amalgamating the municipalities. But I'm definitely against the idea of having a full-time mayor or full-time councillors. For one thing, that means a lot of really qualified people would have to give up their jobs to take part in it. And that's why you have, well-qualified CAOs guide the councillors and the mayor. So I don't really think there's a need to have a full-time mayor. I think that's kind of pie in the sky and also could be quite expensive, too.
So do you think we could get away with sort of like a half-time mayor?
Obviously it's very time-consuming. And, there has to be a fairly decent honorarium. And obviously with a bigger municipality, they're going to get paid more than what they get paid now. But there is, I know it's a lot of time. I've been involved in civic politics myself. I know that can be very, very time-consuming.
Well, there you go. Don, I appreciate your opinion.
Bye now.
Thanks. Have you found any kind of support from area politicians, Sean?
No, I haven't. I haven't spoken with any of the politicians, but I haven't heard anyone else out in the peninsula anyway come out in favor of any of the current politicians coming out in favor of the idea.
Have you approached Mayor Marr about this to see how he feels?
No, I haven't approached Marr. I did ask it at the mayoral breakfast.
Yeah.
and just more about amalgamation of services than the other gentleman asked about the amalgamation of all three of the municipalities. And you generally get the more of a runaround than anything else. I'll tell you one thing, they were ready for the question because they knew it was coming.
Yeah. Okay. What would you do vis-a-vis policing? Because you've got a couple areas that are handled by the RCMP and Central Saanich handled with a municipal force. How would you deal with that?
Well, it is complicated. There's no doubt about that. And it's not going to happen through osmosis overnight or anything like that. Like, there's a lot of stuff that would have to get resolved. One of the great things is the provincial government has a fund set up that if the movement for amalgamation is locally initiated, all sectors of the communities are involved, right, then they have a fund set up where they'll pay to have a consultant come in and answer all those questions, right? So they'll be available for people to see the answers to those. And then you go into the referendum with the knowledge to know what the financial benefits and things like that and how all the details such as police forcing would happen.
Now, would you say this is a main plank of a platform, or is this just one of
No, no, it's not a main plank of my platform by any means. Because, like I said, it's a long-term thing. It's not something that, it's not like, let's say I get elected, all of a sudden, next thing you know, it's amalgamating, right? Like, we're talking about a huge, huge ordeal here, and to put it on the referendum, it's a big process, right? But I'm definitely in favor of starting it, and it's not a main platform issue for me, no.
386-1161, star 1070. Going to take a quick break, and then we're going to talk more with Sean about some other peninsular issues here on CFAX 1070's Newsline PM.
This is Corey Polkinghorne looking to CFAX 1070 traffic and weather together for Pacific Coast floor coverings. Out of the ferries, the 4 o'clock sailing is 62% full. After the 4, sailings at 5, 6, 7, and 9. Lots of sailings out there at Swartz Bay tonight if you're heading over to the mainland. Out on the roads, things are quiet in Greater Victoria right now, but if you do see anything going on, give us a call, 386-1161 or star 1070 on your cell phone. Looking at a CFAX 1070 weather, cloudy periods overnight with lows down to 4. Cloudy tomorrow with a chance of showers later on in the day, highs up to 9 degrees. Cloudy with a chance of showers on Sunday, small chance of showers on Monday, a 60% chance of showers on Tuesday. Currently at the CFAX studios, it's a mix of sun and cloud, 7 degrees.
Pacific Coast floor cover.
Now back to Murray Langdon and Newsline PM on CFAX 1070.
More with Central Saanich mayoralty candidate Sean McNulty and your phone calls as well, 386-1161, star 1070. Alfred, hi, welcome to Newsline PM.
Hi there.
Your take.
Sean, I am enjoying your conversation and I applaud you for moving forward with this. The thing that I think you really identified is the fact that you'll get no support from the police, the fire departments, none of the civil servants, and none of the mayoralty candidates in the areas, because they don't want to lose their turfdom. They can be a big fish in a little pond, and if that pond gets bigger, they get to be either out of the pond or just too small a fish. So it's almost like something that has to happen from the provincial government. The government has to come in and says, you got 5 years. Do it.
Yeah, you're not the first person, Alfred, to say there's a little bit of a feeling of protectionism here. Sean?
Yeah, hey, no, Alfred, I think you hit it right on the head there. It's a great, you know, great point. That it, the people who are currently leading the municipalities, they're not going to want to see this happen. Like, and you can't blame them. I mean, it does in essence work against their best interest. But I think on the whole, in terms of the best interest of all the residents out here on the peninsula, I believe it's the way to go.
Well, now let me ask you a specific question about Central Saanich.
Okay.
You know, this is what I see as one of the problems with the failure to have the area under one blanket. Central Saanich, who like to micromanage everything in their municipality, I live in Central Saanich, it just shocks me how the council just micromanages everything. What do they spend? Was it $1.25 million in that one block between north of... Wallace Drive on West Saanich Road?
The Brentwood Bay Revitalization, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Well, here you have them doing their own little thing, trying to play, you know, I don't know, just... I thought I should write to the Premier and say that there ought to be a law that, you know, council members when voting on issues like this shouldn't be allowed to smoke marijuana first, because I don't know what else they would have been thinking when they went ahead with that plan. Here we have a major access road leading out of the municipality into other municipalities, and they just said, like, to hell with you, other municipalities. We're now going to put in a couple of roundabouts and do this and that and slow down the traffic. So what's going to have to happen going to have to put a bypass road
action. That's not an isolation. If anyone's driven up Fort Street lately, there was concerns that people were going too fast. Now it's a bloody parking lot. I mean, it's got down to one lane, and I know we've had emails about that before. Traffic calming, I think, is the name of the game, but it's certainly not convenient. John?
Yeah, I mean, in terms of the Brentwood Bay Revitalization, I mean, I think I like the look of it, to be honest with you, Alfred. I think in the whole scheme of things, I think it looks good, right? And in the Brentwood Bay Village, I think it's important that that turns into more of a thriving village center. In terms of how they went about it, I mean, the construction costs keep going up. I think the thing that cost them the most there was that it took them 10 years to do, right? So not only was it only about a block and a half or two blocks, I mean, for to do two blocks of that, to argue over it over 10 years, is just so way too inefficient. Yeah, in terms of places like 4th Street, I know also on Esquimalt Road there, I think, yeah, the some emphasis has to be put on traffic flow, because you can't have traffic backing up all over the place, and people have places to go, and then there's also the environmental impact. So, yeah, there's definitely something to be said for that.
Alfred, thanks for your phone call. On the email from Bob, and don't forget, we have the unelected CRD2. Gordon Campbell has to rip up the Municipal Act before any process of amalgamation can happen. Maybe that's where we need to see the province get involved as well, too. I'm not sure you'd have to rip up the Municipal Act.
No. I mean, the province does have I did look it up when I wrote an article about it on my blog, seanfromair.com, but... The province does have a way of making it happen. Like, it just, like I said, it's got to be locally initiated. It doesn't necessarily have to be the municipal politicians that initiate it, but that obviously helps, right? But it just has to be locally initiated. All sectors of the communities have to be involved, right? So you have to have people from in the peninsula, from Sydney, North Saanich, Central Saanich, all the different sectors of it, right? You got the farmers and the businesses and all that. They all get together, and then if they can all agree that they want to take a look at it, then the province steps in with funding and then brings the consultant in, and they handle that aspect of it. So the province does have a way to make this happen. It's just a matter of people within the municipalities getting involved in the process and pushing it forward.
386-1161, *1070. We have a couple minutes left. By the way, you mentioned your website there, seanfromair.com. Is that right?
That's correct. Yeah, it's www.seanfromair.com. I post blogs on there. The idea behind my campaign is I don't want to do the typical political campaign. What I'm doing is I'm coming out and saying what I'm about. I'm being 100% transparent, laying it all out there. There's some things that the residents are going to agree with me about. There's some things that they're going to disagree with me about, but they're going to know what I'm about, and that's the key. And I think that the voters of Central Saanich appreciate honesty and transparency over secrecy and deception. So that's what the blog is all about. And, yeah, if you get a chance to check it out, there's lots of good stuff on there. It talks a lot about the campaign. Talks about the silent majority tour that we're doing, where we're door-knocking every house in the municipality. So it's going to be an exciting November 2008 here.
Anyone else declared yet?
No, you see, this is what I don't like, Murray. Is that like
people want to wait? They like drama.
I think it's a little cowardly, to be honest with you. I mean, it's tough for me because I don't even know who I'm running against, right? So people ask, you know, what's
maybe no one.
What's the difference between you and the other guys? And you say, well, I don't know who the other guys are, right? So I think the 1 month, because technically you don't have to declare that you're running until between 46 days and 30 days before the election, right? That seems a little short for the voters to see what they're getting. You mean you get 1 month to examine a guy who's going to be, you know, in charge of all your tax dollars for 3 years. You know, I think that's one of the something that could be definitely improved in terms of our municipal political system.
Question on the email. Does Sean think he's qualified to be the mayor of this new amalgamated municipality idea?
Oh,
fair question.
But, hey, you know what? I think I do actually think I would be qualified to do the job. I pride myself on my work ethic, you know, Murray. You know, I think with hard work, you can accomplish just about anything. So, yes, I do think I could handle that role.
And the increased salary.
And, hey, whatever comes with it.
So would you give up your business there, too?
If it was a full-time gig, you know, definitely something I'd look at.
But if it's the Central Sanish Mayor's job, then no, it's part-time.
Well, I mean, yeah, it's only, I gotta eat, Murray, so.
No one wants to deprive you of any corn out there, my friend.
No, okay,
you want to make sure you get a... The incumbent hasn't come forward yet. No one's come forward yet.
No.
When are you expecting something?
You know, the sooner the better. I mean, I've definitely heard some rumors of different people, right? I mean, I'd like to challenge that if anyone is running out there in Central Sanish, you know, put your name forward and let's get the debate started early and let's let the people get a real good glimpse of what the different people want to bring to the table in terms of the mayor position of Central Sanish.
www.seanformayor.com. Sean McNulty, thanks for joining us this afternoon.
Hey, thank you for having me.
All right, all the best.
See you then, Ray.
4 o'clock news is next on CFAX 1070. And I would bet we're going to start to see more people throw their hats into the ring. 7 months away. And people like the publicity, like the chance to get their name out there. We'll see. You're more than welcome to do it. Make your announcement. Here's Line PM. We'd be glad to have you. If you think you are going to run in a municipal election, talk at CFAX 1070.com. Let us know. News is next.